Hello everybody, welcome to my video about air fuel ratio and lambda. So what does air fuel ratio mean? Air fuel ratio is the mixture between air and fuel during combustion. So for example, when you have an air fuel ratio of 13.2:1, that means you have 30.2 parts of air and 1 part of fuel. Mostly in engine calibration, there's talked about a lambda value. A lambda value is a deviation percentage to the stoichiometric mixture. The stoichiometric mixture is the most chemically correct mixture during combustion. Then also the combustion is most complete and you have the lowest emissions. A stoichiometric mixture is has an AFR of 14.68:1. This is for gasoline. You have a lambda value is then 1. So what does it mean? So for example, you have an AFR of 11.5:1. You can convert this to a lambda value, then you get lambda is equal to AFR divided to the stoichiometric fuel ratio. It's 14.68. It's 11.5 divided by 14.68, and you get a lambda value of 0.78. So what does this 0.78 means? That means you got 78% of air, of the 100% air you needed for a stoichiometric mixture during that combustion. So when you want to have a stoichiometric mixture with the fuel injected during this combustion where you're at 78%, you needed 22% more air to get that. So also I got some very most likely air fuel ratios and lambda values. So for example, you have this is lean and this is rich. So this is 17 and this is 11. So you get the best economy burn to burn fuel is by an air fuel ratio of 15 to say 16, and you get an if you're around the lambda value around 0.12 to 0.1.9, so then you're running lean. When you are going around 15 to 16, you have also have a much more chance of misfiring and detonation. So with the stoichiometric mixture is at 40.7, you got a lambda value of 1. For a normal aspirated car, you got the most power, most torque around lambda values of 12.6 to 14.3. You got a lambda value then of 0.85 to 0.9. For turbo cars, you need more fuel to cool combustion, and also the temperature is high, so otherwise you get detonation. So for max power in the turbo car, so this is for normal aspirated engines. So for boosted engines and turbo cars, the air fuel ratio should be somewhere around 11.5. Then you got a lambda value of 0.75 and 0.78. Also is nice to know is when you're having an air fuel ratio gauge in your car, that's always connected to an oxygen sensor. An oxygen sensor is only measuring the amount of oxygen in your exhaust gases. So you always get, it's always converted to a lambda value. So for example, you're running on gasoline and you're then going to run with the same gauge on E85 or ethanol, you still get the same lambda value. So for example, but in the air fuel ratio, the stoichiometric mixtures for E85, I thought it was around 9.78:1, but you still you still get the same values, the same lambda values, so it still calculates it to the same values on your gauge. So I hope you all understand it. If there are any questions, leave some comments below, and don't forget to subscribe to the page. Thank you and see you next time. Bye bye.